that which is sort of closer to my heart, all my current series of works are called the Warrior series. And they're about, all of the work in fact is about conflict, opposites and power. So how like the resolution of conflict leads to a greater personal power. And with the Warriors, it's more to do with the internal conflict. And basically, I usually have like one figure, so it's like very paring down to the essentials. And I look at sort of different aspects of being a warrior, so wounded, defeated, victorious. I do research on a lot of mime artists, performance artists, kabuki dancers, Indian dancers. I distort the imagery a lot. I take the head usually from African warriors, distort those two. Combine them. I'm usually looking for a feeling. I kind of respond intuitively to the work, so I'm looking for kind of a fighting spirit. more recently, I've introduced a lot of movement into the work through dance. Although the warriors are not dancing, but it's taken from dancers. And the reason for that is kind of a galvanizing of your internal energies to get into the warrior-like state. And other developments are looking at shamans because they go into a trance-like state, to do with the mending of the soul, if you like. I have a second series of works which are kind of more commercial, and they're satirical works where I satirise politicians and royalty and turn them into kind of caricature, and they're all set into an art historical context. So I select an art history painting chosen for the comedy in relation to the individual that I'm looking at. It's about the political cartoons piece of fine art. I always start with a drawing. If we're talking about painting, then I always start with a full-scale charcoal drawing. But before I even get that far, I do a lot of manipulation graphically, which is a kind of material of itself, and sort of collage and put things together. But for the finished piece, the charcoal drawings sell as them works in themselves. And for the painting, I have a kind of an underpainting of acrylic because it dries faster, and paint on top with oils. I liquefy the paints and pour them, so that's kind of my own way of working to get accidental effects. My first experience of doing any kind of art was about 7. My aunt bought me a set of paints, and I just stood there straight away and painted a rose, and everyone was amazed because it looked like the real rose, and I thought, well, it's supposed to, so what's the big deal about that? So, and then I was always drawing and painting. At school, I decided to go for academic subjects because everyone said it was better, and I wasn't really sure. You know how your parents, if your parents are very traditional, they really want you to be an artist, and I didn't know what I wanted to do. So I worked in merchant banking for quite a while, just being a good girl. And didn't fit in at all. That's far too controversial as a character. Perfectly capable at work. I was still always drawing and painting, going to art classes, and in the end I thought, do you know what, I need to do what I really like, because I really don't enjoy doing the banking. So it was more that I just had to channel my energies into something that I enjoyed. As I said, I think in a way I always was doing that work because I needed to do it. So I continue as an artist because I need to do it. It's not really any other reason. I think for me, when you're actually doing the painting or the drawing, one of the things I really like is that the rest of the world completely disappears. So it doesn't matter if you're going through the most horrific crisis or not, or whatever, if you're worrying about something or whatever, not that of course I ever would, but if you were, really everything disappears. It's about line, mark, tone, colour, getting that image, getting the effects that you want. And some quite special, I think, space or, if you like, escape from the rest of the world. It's very valuable. And if I don't do it for more than a few days, you know, I really have to do it again. It's just an important part of existence.